Now you all can see my screen, right? Are you able to see?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Now,
yes, sir.
Once again, we'll go for the from the beginning of this chapter.
Yes, sir.
Of this concept. So today we are going to discuss square roots. Okay, square root. What is a square root? How to find a square root? What are the different methods, etc., etc., we discuss in this session. So now, firstly, we'll understand when a number is expressed as a product of two equal factors, each of them is called its root. We call it square root. Okay, when a number is expressed as a product of two factors and both are equal, in that case each of them is called its square root. For example, 25 is equal to 5 into 5, therefore square root of 25 is 5, we say. Then 64 is written as 8 into 8, therefore square root of 64 is equal to 8. Next, you can see this explanation for squares as well as their roots. Since 1 square is 1, square root of 1 is 1. Since 2 square is 4, square root of 4 is 2. And you have to remember this tabular form up to 10. Once again, we will see in the coming slides. Just go through this one now. See, so the very idea is, we actually think which number when multiplied by itself gives a square number, and that number is the root of the square number. Meaning, when you are asked to find the square root of 4, what number times itself is 4? This is how you will think. 2 square, 2 into 2 is 4, therefore square root of 4 is 2. For example, 81 again. In 81, 9 multiplied by 9 gives you 81. Therefore, square root of 81 is 9. This way we will remember the square roots. And here is the table of squares and roots now. You can say 1 square, 2 square, 3 square, up to 19 square, 20 square also. 20 square is 400. All these you have to remember. And here is the roots table. Roots table is square root of for every square number we can have its root. We can have its root. 1 square is 1, therefore square root of 1 is 1 again. And 7 square is 49, so square root of 49 is 7. Like this it goes. So all these tables you have to remember up to 20. First 20 we have to remember, so that it will be good for us to do the problems. Even these will come in competitive exams also, as I said in the beginning of this chapter. You see, all the square roots up to 20 I have written. So first 20 square numbers and their roots. 196 is a square number whose root is 14, or 14 square is 196. We can remember like this. So all of you draw this tabular form on your own and paste it somewhere, and every day you look at this so that you can remember easily. So I showed you many methods of remembering squares and square roots. And let us understand how to find the square root of a number now. There are four different methods. One, repeated subtraction method. Another, prime factorization method. The third one, division method. And the fourth one is estimation method. Out of these, we learn today first two methods, repeated subtraction method and prime factorization method. So repeated subtraction method now. So what actually we repeat, or what actually we subtract repeatedly in this method, from a given square number we subtract odd numbers starting from 1 repeatedly till we get 0. This is actually the method. This is actually the method. So here we go. The number of steps we take to reach 0 is nothing but the root, or the square root, of the given number. Children, if the screen is coming very small for you, you can enlarge the screen on your mobiles. Let us take one example and check how this method works. Let us find the root of square root of 36. Now 36 minus 1, first odd number is 1, therefore 36, from 36 we subtract 1, your answer is 35. This is step number 1. In step 2, from 35, from this difference, we subtract next odd number, that is 3. After that, from this difference, I have to subtract next odd number 5, that is step number 3. In step 4, from 27, I will subtract next odd number to 5, that is 7. 27 minus 7 is 20, that is step 4. In step 5, 20, from 20 I will subtract 9 and I get 11, that is step 5. And from 11, next odd number to 9 is 11, I will subtract 11 from 11 and I get 0. When I reach 0, I stop subtraction because further I don't go. Subtraction after getting 0, we stop this process and then and declare that square root of that particular number is number of steps taken. Number of steps taken is 6. Therefore, the square root of 36 is 6 now. This is how
you sir?
Yeah.
Sir, in square and square roots, we should subtract like this only, no sir?
This is one of the methods, my boy. Every time we cannot do like that. For a bigger number, what to do, I will tell you later. You wait, please. Okay? You understand methods one after another. Okay? Next method is, again we will see what is subtraction method, repeated subtraction method. For 64, we do like this. 64 minus first odd number, 1, 63. 63 minus second odd number, 60. And 60 minus third odd number, 5, 55. 55 minus 5, 48, minus 7, 48. 48 minus 9, that is the next odd number to 7, 39. 39 minus 11, 28. 28 minus 13, 15. 15 minus next odd number to 13 is 15, is 0. Therefore, we are getting 0 in 8 steps here. Therefore, square root of 64 is 8. Square root of 8 is 64 is 8. And this has come in the 8th slide. Come, tell me.
So to do this type of separation, we should keep the unit space in mind and the numbers, sir. Means unit numbers, 4 like that, no, sir.
Not required. Afterwards we'll check that. It's not required. We go on subtracting the odd numbers in order, that's all. Okay. We don't keep anything in mind, not required. Given a square number, we go on subtracting from that the odd numbers in an orderly manner first. 1, next is 3, next is 5, next is 7, 9, 11, 13, and how long we'll subtract like this? As you get it, till you get 0. When you obtain a 0 here as the difference, we stop this. Okay? Then come to next one again. Suppose you are asked to find the square root of 100 by subtracting odd numbers successively. That means repeatedly. From 100, I subtract 1, 99. From 99, I will subtract next odd number to 1 is 3, 96. And 0 I obtain here in this process in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 steps. Therefore, we obtain 0 at 10th step. Therefore, square root 100 is 10. Okay, we shall see one more example. 169. From 169, we subtract and check like this. And we obtain 0 in the 13th step. Therefore, square root of 169 is 13. So, in repeated subtraction method, we subtract odd numbers starting from 1 repeatedly till we get 0. As we reach 0, we stop this subtraction and declare the square root is of that particular number is the number of steps we took to get to obtain 0. Okay, I think you have understood this method. Now we will move on to next method. Yashwant, are you following? D. Yashwant, Kyati Sri?
Yes sir.
Yeah. Next, prime factorization method. This prime factorization is an important method, and given a number, how to prime factorize, we learned in 6th class itself, and it goes on up to 10th class. So you have to remember this method, and this prime factorization has many applications. Now one of these is to find the square root. How to find the square root using prime factorization method? We take an example and check that. Before that, let me explain briefly what is this method. In this method, we prime factorize a given square number first, then arrange the primes or prime factors in pairs. From each pair, one factor is taken, and the square root of the number given is the product of all those factors which are chosen. Now let us take an example to understand this method. Right, 64 I took, I prime factorized this. 2, first prime number is 2, so by 2 I divide this one in short division method. Okay, 2, when it is dividing 64, 32 is the quotient. We further divide the quotient by 2 and 16 we obtain. 16 again by 2 we divide and we get 8, and the process goes on till you get one prime number as the quotient here. So 64, when you divide it by 2, you get 32. So again further, 32 is divided by 2 to get 16. 16 is further divided by 2 to get 8. 8 is divided by 2 to get 4. 4 is divided by 2 again to get 2. You understand the process here, I think? Okay, so from here we started like this. Okay, and 2 is a prime number now. 2 is a prime number. So we stop our division here when you obtain a prime number in the short division method. Once you got this prime number, we arrange the factors like this. 64 equal to 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. So there are 3 pairs. 2 into 2 and 2 into 2, 2 into 2. I colored them differently, you can check that. Therefore, from each of these factors, one factor is taken, okay, and those 3 are multiplied. 2 multiplied by 2, 4, and 4 multiplied by 2 is 8. 4 into 2, 8 here. Okay, this is how we do the problem. We find the square root of a number by using prime factorization method. Prime factorization method. Now, shall we move on to next one?
Yes, sir. I think yesterday we discussed this.
So, you can make a note of it quickly. One more example we take, 225. 225 cannot be divided by 2. You know, this is not an even number, it is an odd number.
So that it can be divided by 5, sir.
My dear boy, it is true. But it can be divided by 3 because 3 is a smaller prime number than 5. So we should start with the smallest prime number. Next we got to go to next prime number, not immediately the bigger number 5 or 7 or like that. So 225, whether it is divisible by 3 or not, you check. 2 plus 2, 4, 4 plus 5, 9. 9 is a multiple of 3, therefore it is divisible by 3. So if I start dividing this 225 by 3 first, 3 sevens are 21, and 1 left, 1 5 15, therefore it is 3 fives are 15. Again by 3, 3 twos.
Sir?
Tell me.
Sir, three fives are 15 also, so it can come in 3 15s.
Yeah, see, 225 is divided by 3 here, is it not? So 3 sevens are 21. Up to there you have to go now. Then 1 is left. This is the left out. This is the remainder. 1 and 5, 15. It will become 15. 15 means 3 fives. Now again, 3 sevens are 3. You have to divide 75 by 3. So 3 divides 7 2 times. Okay. 3 twos are 6. 1 is left. 1, 5, 15. 3 fives are 15 now. Again, 25 cannot be divided by 3. So we choose 5 as our next prime number. And 5 5s are 25. We obtain a prime number as our quotient. So we stop division here. Then we arrange the primes in an orderly manner like this. 3 into 3 into 5 into 5 is the prime factorization of 225. And we arrange the prime factors in pairs. And from each pair, we choose one number. And square root of 25 is obtained by multiplying the chosen factors 3 and 5 here. It is 15. So 225, square root of 225 is 15. This is the answer. Okay. Now let us take one more example. 400. We divide it by 2 first, prime factorization. 2 200s are 400. 2 hundreds are 200. 2 50s are 100. 2 25s are 50. Therefore, now we have 5 5s are again. When you obtain 25, 5 5s are 25. That 5 is a prime number, so we stop our division here and arrange the numbers again in factor form. 400 equal to 2 multiplied by 2, 2 multiplied by 2, and finally it is 5 multiplied by 5. So here, the pairs are arranged like this. 2 into 2, one pair. Another 2 into 2, one more pair. 5 into 5, another pair. So from each pair, I choose one number. 2 here, 5 here, and multiply them.
20.
20. 20 is the answer. 2 2 is a 4, 4 5 is a 20. So square root of 400 is 20. Are you all following the presentation here?
Yes, sir.
Is it yes,
sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes,
sir. Good. That's good. That's good. That's good. Now we'll move on to next this one exercise. We're going to go to exercise and do some problems from exercise so that we'll have more practice. This is exercise 6.3. Which could be the possible ones digit of the square root of each of the following numbers? Now, some time back, some 5-10 minutes back, Saket asked this. Ones place we have to see or not. We need not see in general, but whenever it is asked as a question like this, you have to check. Now here four questions are given. 9801, 99,856, and 9,98,001. And the very big number 65766625. Now you can understand that 1 is there in the units digit or ones place here. That means it is a perfect square. This also could be a perfect square. This could be a perfect square. This could be a perfect square.
So all are perfect squares.
All are perfect squares here. Therefore, what will be the possible digit in the ones place we have to find? For this, we need to go to the previous slides. If you want, I can show you. Whenever 1 is coming in the end, its square root will have 1 or 9 in it. Shall we move on to this one? I think you can. Slide number 3, 4, 4 will go. I think 4, slide 4 I'll check. Yeah, here you can see in this slide, you can see the square roots. If 1 is there in the units digit, its square root is 1, or it can be 9 also. Okay, if 4 is there in the square number, its square root will have 2 in the units digit. You can see 4 here and even here also. It can be 8 also, either 2 or 8. Here 4, wherever 4 is there, yeah, this is 4, so it is 2 here. It is 4, it is 2 and 8 here. So again 9 is there. If a 9 is there, it can be 3 or 7. If 9 is there in the end, it can be square root can be 3 or 7. See, one more 9 is there, you can see. It is 13. In the units digit 3 is there. Here in the units digit 7 we have. Suppose it is 6. If it is 6, 4 can be there or 6 can be there. Here you can see 4 and 6. 4 and 6. If it is 5, definitely it will have 5 in the units digit. If it is 0, definitely it will have 0 in the units digit. This tabular form you have to keep in mind. So, if 1 is there in the square number, its square root will have 1 or 9. If 4 is there, its square root will have 2 or 8. If 4 is there, it is 2 or 8, correct? If 9 is there, it is 3 or 7. If it is 6, 4 or 6. And if it is 5, exactly 5. If it is 0, it is 0. So this also you have to keep in mind. Now let us understand how to answer this question now. So what could be the possible digit? This is the question here. So here 1 is there. Therefore, its square root will have either 1 or 9. Here 6 is there. Therefore, its square root will have either 4 or 6. So children, you keep the textbook with you and you may note down the answers quickly in your rough note somewhere, so that afterwards you can make your own classwork. And again 1 is there, therefore 1 or 9. And here it is 5. So what could be the possible ones digit in its square root? Here for the last question you can answer easily.
Sir, 25 sir, 5.
5. So it is 5. Only 5. No other option here. Here there are 2 options, but here only 1 option. If 0 is given at the end, you will have 0 in the square.
0 only, sir.
Now I
so for 5 and 0 only 1 option, sir.
1 option, correct. For 1 it is 1 or 9, for 4 it is 2 or 8, and for 5 it is 5 only 6, it is again 4 or
sir?
6. Yeah,
sir, here in 1 you haven't given that 1 or 9, sir. In 9, oh, sorry sir, I forgot it that in 9 nines I...
Next one, 6.3, second question. Without any calculation, find the numbers which are surely not perfect squares. Which are not perfect squares you have to mark here. See,
sir, I can answer, sir.
You can answer, of course. Let me have the question on the board first. 153, 257, 408, 441. Here 153 will check.
Sir, this was perfect. Sir, first one will not come, sir.
153 is
not the
you can easily three. Say, because 3 is there at the end. 3,
yes.
2, 3, 7 and 8 will never come in the units digit of a perfect square. Therefore, it
first
is...
First 3 are not square,
first
sir.
One,
not only last
three.
One is just
first
one
is
square.
Not a perfect square.
Very second sure. Also not.
Second,
second
one is also not, sir.
One.
Third,
third
one
only.
Third one also
third
not, sir.
Third.
Fourth one is right, sir.
Fourth one is right. It is a perfect square. It can be
fourth
a perfect
one
square.
Perfect
even one
square, sir.
Ah, okay, children. One more concept I would like to give you here. Even if by seeing a number, we cannot easily estimate whether it is a square or not. But we can come to a little bit of, we can say, it cannot be or it can be like that. Surely these are not perfect squares, that is correct. But whether this is a perfect square or not, we cannot decide till we find it. But we can say, it could be a perfect square, we can say. That's all. Now, let us move on to third question here. Third question is an easy one, already we discussed it. And I'll give you the answer quickly here. Find the square roots of 100 and 169 by repeated subtraction method. I already told you, I already taught you this one in the previous slides, in the examples, how to find the square roots of 100 and 169 by repeated subtraction. In repeated subtraction, what do we subtract repeatedly?
Odd numbers, sir.
Odd numbers. Starting from? 1. Starting from?
1, sir.
One.
One, sir.
So, the number of steps we take to get 0 in the subtraction process, that is the square root. So, here from 100, when we subtract odd numbers repeatedly, of course, at the 10th step, you will obtain 0. Therefore, square root of 100 is 10. And square root of 169 is also in the same way. We go on repeatedly subtracting 1, next number 3, next is 5, 7, 9, all odd numbers in a row, in a successive way, we'll subtract, and we obtain 0 at the 13th step. Therefore, square root of 169 is 13. So, 3 questions we completed like this. So, if those who are getting this one on their screen, can you get a screenshot or understand the problem and do it later. Now, shall we move on to the 4th question?
Yes, sir.
I think you understood this repeated subtraction method.
Yes, sir.
Even the same method was applied in this way. For 81, try at home for 81 and one more question you take, 49. 81 and 49 you try at home, or 121 you take. Right. Now 6.3, the 4th question.
Okay, sir.
Find the square roots of the following by prime factorization method. Sure. Prime factorization, you know. What are the questions given here? 729. When you divide 729, you cannot divide it by 2 because it is not an even number. It is a prime, it is an odd number. Therefore, we start with 3. 3 ones, again, 3 twos are 6. 1 is left here. So, after subtracting 6 from 7, we are left with 1. 1, beside that, if you write 2, it is 12. 3 fours are 12. Then, 3 threes are 9. Therefore, 3 we write here. Only the quotient will be given here. Then, 3, when you divide, further you can divide 243 by 3. So, 3 8s are 24, 3 1s are 3. Again, 81 also is divisible by 3 because 8 plus 1 is 9. So, 3 2s are 6. 2 left here. 2 1, 21. 3 7s are 20. 3 7s are 21.
Seven.
Again, 3 9s are 27 in the end, and 3 3s are 9 towards the end. This one. So, we got all the factors here. Now, we can write them in an orderly manner. Right? Then, we can have its square root by choosing the pairs. The pairs are chosen here.
3 3 is 9, 9 3 is 27.
That is the 27 answer here. For
what is
the square root of 729 then? It is 27. This is how we get this by prime factorization method. Shall we do it for 400? 400 already we checked in the previous slide.
It is 20.
And I will show you quickly like this. And we will take, we take two more examples, we take 1764, 4096, they are bigger numbers of course, but still we can do easily like this. 2, by 2 we divide 1764, then you will get 882, again we continue this one. 882 divided by 2, it is 441, and 441, when you divide by 3, you get 147.
42, sir. 42.
49. And the squares are arranged like this now. I mean the factors are arranged like this, and from each pair we take one number, one factor.
42.
And the product of factors will be giving you 42. So I think 42. You understood what is this method. Even for 4096
yes,
also, we'll quickly go through this. It's a long one. You can see a long division has come. Understand the division clearly. 2, 2 2s are 4, again a 0, 2 4s are 8, 1 left, 1 6, 16, so 2 8s are 16. Again 2, 2 10s are 20, 2 2s are 4, 2 4s are 8. Again 2 5s are 10, and 2 1s, 2 2s. Again 2, 2 25s are 50, 1 left, 1 2 12, so 2 6s are 12. Again 256 divided by 2. 2 12s are 24. 1 left. 1 6 16. So 2 8s. Again by 2. 2 6s are 12. 2 4s are 8. 2 32s. 2 16s. 2 8s. 2 4s. And 2 2s. Of course, this 2 is not required here. Now we arrange the factors. The factors will bring like this. How many 2s are there? You will count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12 2s are there, and I made into 6 pairs. From each pair, one number is chosen, and product of all these 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8, 8 2s are 16, 16 2s are 32, 32 2s are 64. 64 is the square root of 4096. Here 42 is the square root of 1764. Like this we can use prime factorization method to find the square roots. Rupi Jimmy?